exploring rec swim, swim lessons, other aquatic programming, and how we can fit it all into Highlands High School. But we're pleased and somewhat relieved that the process went fairly quickly, and we do have the pool secured for our swim team for next, for 2015. That's all I have.
Thank you, Terry.
No, sure.
All right, under correspondence, we received a very beautiful thank you letter from Friends for Survival. And do we have any comments and reports from citizens and organizations? I don't think so. And unfinished business, Twin Rivers School District pool closure letter. So, do you have anything to add to that, Harry?
Well, just a reminder, as you probably picked up in the letter, that Twin Rivers, in our previous meeting that Scott and I had with their finance folks and their assistant superintendent, they had an interest of wanting to know how much money we've made at the pool over the last 50 years. I'm reluctant to share that with them for several reasons. One, it would probably take the manpower of three people for a full year to try to go back and look at things from what happened 50 years ago. But more importantly is that in our contract, when it talks about at the end of our contract, if we choose not to renew, and it makes a statement along the lines of that the school district will need to look at reimbursing our district for out-of-pocket costs for facility improvements. But at no time does it ever mention the term, phrase, or word of revenue. And I've made that clear to them in a written response I sent back to them. We'd be happy, Scott and Terry have been working on tracking down the invoices and the information we have, even going back to talking to Kay to look at her memory of the things that may have taken place that we're not finding all the documentation for. But we would be happy to prepare, share with them all the documents that are relevant to that particular component of the contract. But I see no reason to provide them with revenue information when it's not a requirement. In fact, I don't see how it's relevant at all, to be honest with you. So anyhow, as you see, the pool will officially close on the 17th. Staff has been, maintenance staff and recreation staff have been over the pool removing all our belongings, things that are valuable to us, things that belong to the district. We've informed the Twin Rivers that per their letter, we would be, we'd have all this removed and be out of the pool by the 17th. At that point, then the pool is turned back over to them. The good point of this is that we no longer have to use one of our maintenance people 20 hours a week to provide maintenance service on a year-round basis, so we can reallocate his hours to other district needs.
All right, thank you. Do you have any questions? Under new business, payment of bills. So did anyone have any questions regarding this month's bills?
Can I ask one thing real quick? Under administrative report, this does kind of go with payment of the bills. Your fiscal reports summary, Larry, does the $5,500 shortfall or the $55,000 revenue shortfall, any concern there, or is that just for the season and typical for this time of year?
Shortfall? That's actually the revenue we received to date.
Oh, that's not?
No, okay. That's what we collected so far since July.
Got you, okay. Yeah. I was just reading that wrong. I thought, uh-oh, what happened here?
I'm going like, I didn't
yeah.
You know, one of the things that we're, as we start to develop a base of this information, we can go back and start looking about, and really more important than the dollar amounts is the percentage of what we're spending. So we'll be able to start getting, soon adding another column to this to show you as a comparison a year ago to that month what it was looking like. So that gives you an idea if you're spending more or less than what you've been tracking over previous years.
I like looking at this report every month, so I just...
Well, it's really all the information is in your report. I'm just stealing it all and kind of putting it on one page for you so you don't have to go searching for it.
I love one page summaries. Okay, I'm sorry.
So do you
have
a question?
Yes, please.
to accept the payment of those as presented.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Three ayes, two absent. And the next meeting of the North Highlands Recreation Park District will be October 9th, 2014, 6:30 in the North Highlands Recreation Center, 6040 Watt Avenue.
And a special meeting prior to that.
And we will have a special meeting prior to that at 5 o'clock. This meeting is adjourned.